Welcome to the Civil War. My name is Jason Diltz. I'm a surgeon with the 27th New Jersey Field Hospital. A lot of things happened during the Civil War. One of the biggest things was our amputations. If you look at the table here behind me, you'll see some of the instruments that we have. We have the bone saw, of course. That was what we used for the larger bones, the upper arm, the upper leg, or anything lower. We also had our bone knives. This would be something that we would use for fingers or the smaller bones, separating bones. We had bone files. Whenever we did an amputation, we would want a nice end to the bone before we put the flap over, so bone files. Along with our surgical instruments, we of course had our drugs that we used during the Civil War. Chloroform, okay, we did use chloroform. A lot of people are under the misconception that we had nothing that we could give our soldiers. We did have chloroform. We also had some of the pain medications, the opium and the morphine that we used. We were able to give our soldiers some of the pain medication. Believe it or not, a lot of people are also under the misconception that it was the amputation that caused a lot of the deaths during the Civil War, and that was incorrect. Disease was the biggest killer of soldiers during the Civil War, not our amputation. But everybody's very familiar with the amputation and the reasons why we did it. And they also are under the wrong conception of why we did it. The reason we did the amputations was it was better to have a live soldier that was missing a limb than it was to have a dead soldier. So the amputation was done because we could not put bone back together, so we would do the amputation, give them a nice stump at the end of the amputation, and send them off for prosthetics. So during the Civil War, amputation was a large thing that we did, prosthetics afterwards. So there you go, a little bit on the American Civil War.